Nearly 2 miles off the coast of Senegal lies Goree Island. To get there, we leave the harbor on a ferry filled with tourists. Eager as I am to visit one of Senegal's most famous landmarks, I'm already familiar with its dark past.
Goree Island was a strategic trading post used during the Atlantic slave trade. Hundreds of men, women, and children were brought to this island, held captive for many, many months before being shipped off to a horror that they couldn't imagine. There are many of these trading posts dotting the landscape across the coast of West Africa. Every time I come to one of these, I get a really eerie feeling that washes over me.
The building that housed the captives, separating families, condemning them to a life of bondage, is now a museum and a monument to human suffering. El Wakoli has been its curator for almost 30 years.
Captives lived inside in so bad sanitation conditions that the first plague epidemic that ravaged the entire island of Goree in 1779 took place from a house like this.
This room is not more than 12 feet across, 12 feet wide, and I can't imagine 20 human beings stuffed in this room, not knowing why they're here, where they're going, what's happening to them, being here for months at a time.
Because they considered captives not as a human being. It was just a simple merchandise.
Why did you feel so importantly to maintain it?
Just to keep this place as a place of memory and reconciliation. That's the vision of the House of Slaves of Goree.
But Goree Island is no longer a house of pain, a place of dark winding corridors with shadows flickering against the crumbling bricks.
This island would have been the last time these captives ever set foot on African soil before they headed out across the sea,
leaving through what was called the door of no return. Vladimir Dutier, Goree Island, Senegal.